Elantra GT is a front-wheel drive hatchback, motivated solely by a 161-horsepower 2.0-liter inline-4 that pairs with a standard 6-speed manual transmission or an optional 6-speed automatic. It was the slowest in our acceleration tests, but it still felt peppy around town and competent on the highway. Unlike many competitors that have switched to smaller engines with turbocharging, the GT makes power with a larger engine but no turbo. The GT Sport version, reviewed separately, is different. Fitted with a 201-horsepower turbocharged 1.6-liter inline-4, the hotter GT Sport hatch zipped from 0 to 60 miles per hour in 6.6 seconds, while the mild standard GT took 8.0 seconds. Still, the 2.0-liter had substantial pull at low revs. We even squawked the front tires after matting the accelerator at an intersection. However, its responsiveness plateaus at higher RPM, where coarse engine noise also plagues the cabin. While we've yet to test it with the manual gearbox, the automatic is amicable but lazy. This transmission includes a sport mode, which sharpens shifts and improves engine response. The Elantra GT isn't a hot hatch. The GT Sport version defends that title, and reasonably well, but its chassis does offer competent handling without sloppy body motion. Too bad its mediocre acceleration, low fidelity steering, and uneven brake pedal response diminished the fun factor compared with sharper alternatives. The Hyundai hatch finished last in every acceleration test, including an 8.0-second run from 0 to 60 miles per hour that was 0.3 seconds slower than its nearest rivals. The GT won't offend laid-back drivers, but its non-turbo engine is less compelling than most competitors. We did like our test car's lively throttle response at low revs, and its automatic transmission was inconspicuous. Pushing the sport button on the center console sharpened the responses of both the throttle and the transmission, which helped, but the setting isn't available with the manual gearbox. The Elantra GT we tested had a remarkable ride over the wide variety of road surfaces that canvass Southeast Michigan. It never felt unsettled on bumpy sections, passengers were well isolated from harsh impacts, and the lack of shakes and rattles bode well for build quality. Our test vehicle rode on 17-inch wheels wrapped with all-season rubber. While its 0.83 grams tied the Volkswagen Golf in our maximum cornering tests, the Hyundai felt less composed than the VW when hustled. Still, the GT had competent handling below the absolute limit and a balanced chassis that avoided feeling lifeless. Its light steering was accurate but lacked the feedback of rivals such as the Mazda 3 and the Golf. The Elantra GT required 171 feet to stop from 70 miles per hour in our emergency braking test, which was 2 feet longer than the Golf. The Chevrolet Cruze hatchback halted shorter than everything, at 161 feet. The Hyundai's brake pedal was oddly inconsistent in its response, with a firmer feel in stop-and-go city traffic and less fight on the highway.